Hi, I'm Penny and this is Fraser and this is Study Time Strategy video for Level 3 Aqueous Systems.
This standard has a few key parts to it. There's pH calculations, solubility, buffers, titration curves and species in solution. This standard has by far and away the most maths out of any Level 3 chemistry standard, and that tends to freak people out a little bit. But the thing that I think you should really focus on is try and figure out why you were doing the maths. You know, in response to not know, to having to do a lot of maths, students tend to freak out and try and memorize what to do, but try and figure out why you're doing it. So for example, why you're setting the solubility to 4s cubed, or why you're making the H0 plus concentration and the A minus concentration equal to each other. That way, if NCEA throws a curveball at you, which classic NCEA, they're totally likely to do, you will not be as caught out as someone who just memorized it. The other thing in the standard is to always keep C equals N over V and N equals M over M in your mind. Quite often they will ask for masses or number of moles at the end of a question, but you will always be working in concentrations in your calculations. So it's really important to reread the question at the end and just make sure you've given them what they've asked for.
Quite often you're expected to write out reactions from paragraphs. You'll get given a whole bunch of information, just like in maths, and you're expected to extract the information from that paragraph and write out the reactions. For example, if you're asked to calculate the pH of 0.1 moles of NH4Cl, you would first have to write the reaction of what happens to the salt when it dissociates. You would get NH4 plus and Cl minus. And then you would have to see what happens when you react NH4 plus with water. So then you would get NH3 and H3O plus. You can then go on to calculate the pH, or write out an expression for the equilibrium constant, or you can check out the different amounts of species in the solution. You're almost always expected to write out a reaction in this standard with most questions.
Another key question in this standard is asking about how the solubility of a salt will change when you change something about your solution, whether that be the pH, whether that be having another salt already dissolved in the solution, or changing the solvent to something that's not water. The key thing to remember here is that it always comes back to Le Chatelier's principle. So as a bit of a recap from last year, Le Chatelier's principle is whenever you make a change to the system's going to try and do the opposite to counteract the change. So if we think about something like silver chloride, for example, if we already had some sodium chloride in solution, that would bump the chloride concentration way up. And what's that going to do to our equilibrium? Well, it's going to try and counteract the change. So it's going to move in favor of the silver chloride, making it less soluble, so less will dissolve. Another thing that they are quite keen on doing every now and again to catch you out is introducing complex ions into the system. So the key things that they are looking for, the key ones that come up, are the silver amine complex and the zinc hydroxide complex. We won't go too much more into that here. Definitely check out the Study Time walkthrough guide for help on that. A lot of the standard is about the maths and the tiny little conversions you have to do while doing the maths. So always reread the question at the end to make sure that you've given them what they're actually asking for. Another key thing is to always write your chemical equations. They will form the basis of your argument 90% of the time. So it's a really key idea to ask what's happening in solution and then writing a chemical equation to represent that.
While we've covered a lot of things today, we haven't quite covered everything. We would strongly recommend that you do 3 to 4 past exam papers and check out our Study Time walkthrough guides.
Have a good time in your exam!